result that this has happened, add more and more energy. Now for a child, like, okay, if you've got a promotion, you visualize that you've got a promotion, people are coming and congratulating you, you're feeling very happy, your parents are happy, your spouse is happy. The more energy you add to this thought, it will be better for you. This reminds me of a story of a man who was very poor. One day, he heard a lecture somewhere and he said, God, I want to have lots of money. Then he added little energy to it. I want to count lots of money every day. And he kept on giving that thought. In the end, he landed up counting money, but someone else's money, as a cashier in the bank. So what he did is, he was not precise. He was not particular as to what exactly. He should have said, I want to count my money in my bank. Instead, he said, God help me to count money. Give me lots of money and help me to count it. God helped him, but he was not precise. Okay, next. Next. Okay, it's okay. When you are giving these emotions or affirmations to your visualization, they should be short, precise, and positive. Remember, your subconscious mind is like a soldier. It does not analyze. It only takes a yes or a no. The second one. Now, whatever you create, whatever you think, whatever you visualize, culminates into a reality. So, like in olden days, elderly people say, shup shup bolo, shup shup socho. It's something like that. They did not foresee why. They could not explain why. But this is the reason. Next. The power to move the world is in your subconscious mind. Your subconscious mind is like a reservoir which has memories of lifetimes, several lifetimes. But it only accepts a yes or a no. It only accepts positive affirmations. It does not analyze. If I do this, or if I think of this, what is the result? Next. Your subconscious mind only obeys the commands. It does not analyze. Next. I've already covered it. Your subconscious mind is like a gardener. When you sow the seeds, if you don't sow the right seeds, woh beej babul ke to phool kahan se paoge. If you sow the seeds of a cactus, you cannot expect a plant of roses. So the conscious mind is like a gardener. It is our responsibility to be aware of and choose what you are feeding in your inner mind, your inner world, or your subconscious mind. So you have to ensure what goes in your inner garden. Now, just to summarize, our mind, we live simultaneously in two worlds, the inner world and the outer world. The outer world consists of the circumstances, the situations that we live in. The inner world is a reflection of what happens in your outer world. So in order to have a positive result, end result, you have to make sure that you control your inner world. And how will you do that? Sorry? Seeding. Seeding. No, seeding. visualization and seeding. Next. You have to be conscious of what you are thinking as you are creating your future with your now thoughts. So every moment, whatever you think, it is repeated. It gets energized and it culminates into the end result. Next. Do not feel sorry for yourself. Work through it through mind power. How will you work? So if you say, I'm sick, I'm not getting this, I'm not getting that, what are you feeding yourself? Negative thoughts. So what you have to do is feed yourself with positive thoughts. Even if you're not well, say, I'm better than yesterday. And that way you can change your thoughts. Next. Establish an inner creating period for yourself, free from daily demands and distractions. Make time for yourself. If you cannot take out 10 minutes for yourself in a day, it is not worth living, I would say. If you don't have 10 minutes for yourself, 5 minutes per seeding and 5 minutes for visualization, giving little energy, visualizing the end result, and whatever, if a negative thought passes your mind, you replace it with a positive thought. Can anyone give me a negative thought? Then I can explain it to you better. Any negative thought?
I'll fail in my exams.
Okay, I'll fail in my exams. Immediately you substitute with, I have passed, successfully completed my exams. People are congratulating me. You see your mark sheet, see your name on it. See that you have successfully come out of the examination. And that's the end. And then just leave the thought. Every day you add whatever you want to. See your friends congratulating you. Add your parents congratulating you. Parents feeling happy. They are sharing with the others. They are distributing sweets. Whatever thought that comes to your mind, you just add to it. Now if you practice this half-heartedly, you will not achieve anything. What does it mean? If you do not put enough force, enough energy to your thought, you will not be successful. Nothing is beyond reach if you have a clear vision, commitment and understanding. Nothing is impossible in one word. The word impossible does not exist in mind power. If you say this is impossible, you will never be able to achieve it. If you do something half-heartedly, oh, I am doing this, but will this help me? It will not help you. Am I clear? That's the end? I think that's the end. Visualization with energy, with seeding, with positive affirmations, precise, positive, and you see the end result culminating, and that is how you can control your mind power. That is how you change your mind, you direct your mind, you train your mind. Is that clear? Meditation. Huh, yes. But you're putting energy, right? Energy in motion is effort, no? Sorry? True. The very fact. Sorry, huh? But little effort you have to put in. Little effort and maximum visualization. It helps a lot. It helps a lot. Try it.
25-75 meditation.
No, 50-50 ratio. meditation. Music, anyone? We will now do a meditation. Very true. See, you have your preconceived notions, your phobias, your fears. You have to substitute all this with a positive thought. Like, there are people who say, if I go to the seashore, I will drown. That's a phobia, a fear. You substitute it with a thought that while you're walking, you're able to enjoy the breeze, you're able to enjoy the sea, the rumbling of the sea, and that's it. It's less, no? Less, no? Yes, we are using how much of your mind? 2% of your mind. You cannot use more. Use what you are using judiciously. Unless you want to surpass Albert Einstein. Okay? We'll do a small meditation before we close. I think it's a Japanese song. Japanese or Chinese? One of the two. Japanese meditation.
I would not know. We are in Singapore.
And he just picked up a CD because we like the movie, the song. Yeah. One second. Hold it. Banka. Ek minute, Banka. Don't cross your feet. Put your palms up. Just follow my voice. I hope all the mobiles are off.